Welcome to Shree Learning Academy. Our today's topic is Downgrade Attack. So let's get started. Understanding Downgrade Attacks, an overview. Imagine you're sending a letter in a locked box to a friend. You and your friend both have strong, modern locks and keys, but just in case something goes wrong, you also have an old, easily picked lock. A sly thief who's been watching you decides to meddle. He intercepts your letter, switches your modern lock with the old one, and sends it on its way. Now, your friend receives the box, unlocks it with the old key not knowing any better, and sends you a reply. The thief can now easily pick the lock, read the reply, and even alter it if he wants to. This is the basic premise behind a downgrade attack in the digital world. Decoding downgrade attacks. A downgrade attack, in its simplest form, is a type of security exploit where the attacker tries to force a network connection to use an older, less secure form of communication. Think of it like forcing two people speaking in a sophisticated code language to revert to plain English, making it easier to understand their conversation. When your computer client talks to a server, like a website, they typically use advanced encryption to secure their conversation. However, to accommodate older systems that might not understand these new languages, both client and server often also support older, less secure forms of encryption. In a downgrade attack, an attacker intercepts the initial handshake or negotiation phase between the client and server. They trick the server into believing the client can only speak an older, more vulnerable encryption language. This results in the server downgrading its encryption level to match the perceived abilities of the client. The attacker can now exploit the vulnerabilities in the older encryption method to intercept, read, or even manipulate the conversation between the client and server. Man-in-the-middle and real-time traffic manipulation. An important concept to understand when discussing downgrade attacks is the man-in-the-middle attack, often used alongside downgrade attacks. Imagine you're talking to your friend on a walkie-talkie, but unbeknownst to you, a mischievous third party has another walkie-talkie on the same channel. They can hear your conversation and even interrupt it to impersonate your friend. In the digital world, this is a man-in-the-middle attack. In the context of a downgrade attack, the man-in-the-middle can intervene during the initial handshake between client and server. They alter the messages, convincing the server that the client can only understand an older encryption language. This is the real-time traffic manipulation mentioned in the main topic. The risk of backward compatibility. To appreciate why downgrade attacks are possible, we need to understand the concept of backward compatibility. This is a design choice in software and technology to ensure newer systems can still communicate with older ones by supporting older protocols and technologies. While this might be beneficial for maintaining system interoperability, it can be a liability from a security perspective. By keeping the door open for older, less secure protocols, systems expose themselves to potential downgrade attacks. It's like keeping that old, easily picked lock as a backup. It might help if you lose the new key, but it's also an opportunity for thieves. Downgrade attacks in action, the POODLE attack. The POODLE, padding oracle on downgraded legacy encryption, attack is a perfect example of a downgrade attack in action. This attack, which emerged in 2014, targeted the Secure Sockets Layer, SSL, protocol, specifically its 3.0 version. The SSL protocol is used for securing connections between clients and servers over the internet. It has evolved over time, with newer versions like Transport Layer Security, TLS, offering more robust security. However, for backward compatibility, many servers also supported SSL 3.0, an older, more vulnerable version. In a POODLE attack, an attacker, operating as a man in the middle, could manipulate the handshake messages between client and server. This forced them to use the vulnerable SSL 3.0, even if they both supported more secure TLS versions. Once the connection was downgraded, the attacker could then exploit vulnerabilities in SSL 3.0 to decrypt and access information, like cookies, from the client-server conversation. The POODLE attack is an excellent illustration of how downgrade attacks operate. It uses the man-in-the-middle technique to force the use of an older, more insecure protocol and then exploits the weaknesses in that protocol. Mitigating downgrade attacks, proactive security measures. While downgrade attacks pose a significant security risk, measures can be taken to mitigate their potential impact. One effective defense against downgrade attacks is disabling the support for older encryption options and backward compatibility with less secure systems. In essence, this is like throwing away the old, easily picked lock entirely. The client and server would then only communicate using the most secure, up-to-date encryption methods. However, this might not always be feasible, especially in systems where interoperability with older systems is critical. In such cases, security protocols can be designed to include protections against downgrade attacks. For instance, the latest versions of TLS include a mechanism where the client and server remember which versions they both support. If an attacker tries to force them to use an older version, they would detect the discrepancy and abort the connection. Furthermore, it's important to constantly monitor and update systems as new vulnerabilities are discovered. The POODLE attack was only possible because SSL 3.0 had a flaw that wasn't present in newer versions. Regularly updating systems and staying informed about emerging threats can go a long way in securing connections. Conclusion. Downgrade attacks are a potent cybersecurity threat that leverage the balance between system compatibility and security. By manipulating the negotiation process between clients and servers, attackers can force them to use less secure encryption methods, making it easier to eavesdrop and manipulate their conversations. Understanding this form of attack, the contexts in which it thrives, and how to mitigate its risks are essential for maintaining secure digital systems. Security is an ongoing process, requiring us to continuously learn, adapt, and enhance our defenses against emerging threats like downgrade attacks. As we move forward in the digital age, the understanding and prevention of such attacks become even more critical, underscoring the importance of robust cybersecurity measures and awareness. By focusing on proactive steps such as disabling backward compatibility where possible, adopting secure protocols, and ensuring regular updates, we can considerably lower the risks posed by these downgrade attacks. Thank you so much for watching this video. Do check out the written explanation on our website and don't forget to take this quiz based on this video. The links are in the description box below. Subscribe to our channel to watch more interesting videos. If you have any doubts, do let us know in the comment section and we will try our best to solve them for you. For private coaching, do contact us by visiting shreelearningacademy.com or on WhatsApp. See you in the next one.